My brethren, today is indeed a special day for all of us gathered here as we commence the 21 days intercessory prayers for our dear country, our dear country and our beloved president, and other worthy sons and daughters on whose shoulders that task of the leading of this great nation fall upon them. It is not by accident that we are gathered here today. It is indeed a divine mandate given to us by the Most High in fulfillment of His promise to liberate Nigeria from the clutches of the evil ones. In the book of Matthew chapter 18, verse 19 to 20, again I say to you, that if two of you will agree on earth about anything that they may ask, it shall be done for them by my Father who is in heaven. For where two or three have gathered together in my name, I am there in their midst. We shall also pray for God's guidance and wisdom as they continue to render services to this country. We shall also pray for God in His infinite mercy to continue to protect them. We shall also be praying for our gallant troop engaged in various security operation against the country. We shall call on God to cover them with His armor of righteousness against all forms of evil. We shall pray to God to continue to grant them unity of purpose as they continue to engage all criminal elements against the country. We shall also pray against all forces of darkness in Nigeria that have been elected to be on the side of the devil through inferior way. We shall pray against all those that have been laying ambushes in various parts of the country, using landmines to be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. We shall also be praying for an end to the attended destruction caused by COVID-19's pandemic. We shall speak to God in one voice to send down the rains to cleanse our land and heal our diseases. We shall say to God that whatever the devil and his cohort intend to do in Nigeria with the COVID-19 pandemic will not see the light of the day in Jesus' name.
My brother and sister, the word from the holy books should result as that our gathering here shall not be in vain. For God, in His infinite mercy, knows our heart desires for our dear country, for the enemies outside and the enemies within. We have to thank God for His grace upon our life as Nigerians, and therefore we shall be praying for the Chief of Defense Staff, General Gabriel Olunosheke, the Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Tukur Buratai, the Chief of Naval Staff, Vice Admiral Ibok Ete Ekwe Abbas, the Chief of Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar, the Inspector General of Police, Muhammad Adamu, and the Director General of the State Security Service, Yusuf Magaji Bichi. We can thank God enough for the numerous sufficiencies that have relegated the Boko Haram terrorist group to the ignoble act of planting landmines across the country, Nigeria.